Gotta play?
Alright, homies.
I gotta go play. I'll try to be back on the mic later.
Okay, and we're live. Okay, perfect. Okay, so this is a big deal right now, because it's two of the big homies, Dyce and Chrim Foish, playing off. Should be fun.
Chrim Foish is not using cloud.
No, he's using cloud.
He is?
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah, because whenever we play friendlies a lot, that's what I'm saying. So we always play friendlies, and he does like to go cloud versus Dyce. Because Dyce knows that Diddy matchup.
And this is huge, right? Because he's never like used Cloud before in bracket, I believe.
Yeah, it's very rare for him to choose it, but I guess he's taking it not so serious.
Especially in this matchup, I feel like he won't be prepared.
Yeah. Well, then again, from my experience playing Dyce, Cloud does do very well against this character.
Yeah.
It's just with Diddy, I feel Dyce really does know the matchup because he knows what to do with bomb. He knows how to control items. So he's really good with banana as well. And so, even though it is Chrim Foish, of course, but like, I feel like it might just be like, if Dyce is able to take this game, then Chris can just switch back to Diddy.
Yeah, switch back. You're right.
Yeah.
But like, Cloud, also his sword is like twice as big as Tooling sword, right? That's
yeah.
The big factor.
Yeah, Tooling got that like butter knife, and he got that big like, that steak, that big meat carver, so.
Okay. He's at kill percent, right? To a bomb, fair.
Yeah, bomb to fair. Bomb to fair or even bomb to back air. He does have bomb to up air as well. It all just depends on the scenario.
Down air and neutral.
Yeah.
I think one of Cloud's like bread and butter, right? Down air, full hop down.
Oh!
That would have been it, too.
Yeah, that definitely would have been it, yeah. That's the thing with these, with the Battlefield, Smashville and Town and City, those small side blast zones, it really does help Cloud, especially when he's new ledge. He's gonna go for that up smash. Oh, he's going for that footstool tech.
That makes up.
Yeah. It's a reset if he gets the footstool, so.
Interesting. He threw the bomb backwards, right, when he hit his shield?
Yeah, it might have just been a flub. He always is trying to get those bombs on point, so. That's the thing, Dyce is very good with his bomb play. Like, sometimes if he knows you're expecting it, he'll, like, run around you and try and psych you out, so.
And his cross slash is not working out.
Yeah, that was actually a really good shield, yeah. And honestly, this is on the way to be looking like a two-stock, because I feel like Dyce, it is pretty difficult to kill Dyce, because he usually is the small character, he's running around all over the place.
He's running around.
Yeah. He's very mobile when he plays, yeah.
And Cloud is not that good when he has to chase the opponent, right?
Yeah.
Which isn't quite common because like, he's usually like, charging and running around himself.
Yeah, his frontal approach options aren't the greatest, but if he does catch him with a bomb at this percent, he will die. Well, that should be it. That's it.
Called it.
Clean two-stock coming from Dyce. Hopefully this boosts his confidence. Hopefully he can ride this momentum for the Chrim Foish Diddy switch. This is looking hype.
Taking a swig of his water. I wonder if he's going to change at all. Sometimes like players don't change because they think they can do the matchup, right?
But yeah.
See here.
Most likely a disgusting stages. I don't think he's most likely... Oh, he's going to stay.
He's staying, yeah. Confident Chrim Foish.
I have played his cloud before. It is pretty aggressive, I'd say. I don't think it's defensive enough.
Yeah.
He does go for like a lot of run up air, a lot of run up in air, so... We'll see how it goes. I feel like Dyce did do very well that game.
He did really well. He was running around. Got the matchup that should be played.
Then again, this stage is really good for Cloud, so we'll see how it goes. Maybe because of these triplots, he'll be able to get a lot more juggles. But... My job actually getting that out.
Chrim Foish actually giving like, him room to come back.
Yeah. I'm
surprised. Up throw back here. Yeah, that's a bomb.
Decent follow from the bomb, actually. And he has limit, so he'll most likely save it for maybe around 30 more percent or so. Maybe around 100, maybe 90. He will be able to kill.
Okay, but oh. The regrab. No punish.
No punish. He could have just ran up and down it, and that would have killed, actually. Oh, bad. Yeah, Dyce is, I feel like he's playing a little bit more shove now. He has a... Okay, there you go. Get some decent follow-ups.
Okay, he has to confirm the limit now.
Yeah.
That was a clean boomerang. That's on stage back row.
That's another thing. Dyce has been really good at mixing up his off-ledge options. He's always been mixing it up, and so Krimfoish isn't able to capitalize on his get-up options.
Up smash. Oh,
oh, he was going for
he
the forward smash.
Him, yeah. I feel like if he missed, it would have been huge, right?
Yeah, that definitely. He probably would have hit with the first smash that would have connected to the second, so he would have been dead. This is scary percent. Oh. Yeah, yeah. That was actually really bad on Krimfoish. Okay, oh, he breaks the shield!
But he has a bomb. Does he have a bomb?
Oh, he does have a bomb! Wait! Is he gonna... Oh, okay. That I think he should have charged that. He definitely should have charged
he
that.
He had a swing. That was crazy.
I was so scared. I thought that bomb was gonna explode and he was gonna be free.
It's interesting. Like, different clouds, you use a limit in different ways. Like, a lot of some clouds, like, you hold onto it, use the improved stats that it has. Some clouds just swing right away, right? They just shoot out whatever they can.
Yeah, that's definitely Chris. Chris is definitely a swinger.
He's a swinger. Swang Chris.
Yeah, swing. Yeah. Yeah. Thankfully for Chris, earlier in that situation, that bomb was fresh, so it didn't explode on him, and it didn't save him. So, but honestly, Dyce not taking too much percent. Oh, that should be it. Oh, limit. He barely survived. He got really lucky.
Do you see how far, like, horizontal he was?
Yeah, that F tilt.
Maybe he DI'd badly on purpose, you know?
Maybe.
Oh,
bad save spike. Okay.
Yeah, no follow up. I feel like he's gonna get on a downer.
Yeah, downer is pretty simple to get on Toon, to be honest.
Cross stage doesn't
work. Battlefield really saving Krimfoish here. And one option I do see Dyce use a lot is that down air on the ledge when Cloud is recovering, because it doesn't sweet spot. So usually there's a wind box and it does mess up because it does go through the ledge too, so I'm surprised he didn't go for it.
Dyce really can't get anything going.
Oh, that
bad
was...
Bad trade for Dyce.
Yeah, really bad trade. He needs something going right now.
Oh, might use a blade beam. Oh, never mind.
Does he tech it? No.
Dude, that is so hard to tech.
It
no
is,
one ever
it
techs
is
it.
Very hard to
never.
Tech. Because, like, normally you're waiting for it to end, but there's that small pause, and then you hit the stage. Plus, he was very close to the stage, too. Might have been untouchable.
Multi-hit, and then there's that pause. So close to the stage. 1-1. No,
yeah.
I call Chris Captain Charisma, because, like, he always, like, livens up the mood and all that.
Yeah.
I feel like it's, like, a good name for him, right?
Yeah, that's definitely, yeah.
Captain Charisma.
And it goes with the C's. Krimfoish,
yeah,
Chris.
That's
yeah, it goes
that's
goes
another
with
one.
Yeah.
CCC, eh?
And actually, game one, we did see a two-stock from Dyce, and then game two, we saw a two-stock from Chris, so... We'll see how game three goes. Chris might just carry all this momentum, and then... Oh, okay. I'm surprised he's actually going Diddy Kong now. I feel like he should have gone Diddy Kong like last game, but I guess he wants to play it safe.
It could be like a counter pick, right?
Oh, stage counter
pick.
Yeah.
Yeah, doesn't want to play on the stage.
I'm not sure going up to you. Okay.
Go to planes.
3, 2, 1, go!
Okay, so yeah, now we can see Dyce's experience in this matchup, because he does like to say he's very well versed in this, so we'll see how it goes.
I feel like a lot of characters who have projectiles and play against Diddy, they should like focus on that, right? They should abuse their projectiles against him.
Yeah.
When he has a banana, then he's really hard to play in neutral.
That is true, because his options are so limited at that point. So that if you're throwing projectiles at him, you have that wall set up. He can't really do much.
Okay, you see that point blank pop gun shot in his face? Yeah. Trying to make a statement out here. Oh my God, monkey flip cross stage.
Yeah. Somehow doesn't get punished, actually. He's been doing a lot of these monkey flips and isn't getting punished for it, so.
Wow, amazing nice bomb snipe.
Yeah, that was a really nice call out. Well, normal get ups into the banana. It doesn't work out, but. Really doesn't get punished too hard.
all the stage control, all the damage. Gets it up. And does he, like, shield work while he has a bomb out or no?
Sorry?
Like, while Toon's holding the bomb, does the shield, like, work?
Yeah,
it does?
Shield does work, yeah.
Even when he's holding the bomb?
Oh, no, 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 it doesn't, it doesn't. Because the shield becomes, it goes on his back.
Okay.
So you won't be able to just stand there and hold the block of banana.
Alright, and clean conversion, down tilt, up smash.
Yeah, you can definitely tell Chris was feeding for it, because he was having the banana, he was just moving back and forth, leaving in, waiting for his option to approach.
When Diddy's at kill percent, there's like two stuff you have to watch out for, the down tilt up smash or the banana up smash, right?
Yeah.
Always keep those two in mind.
And always have your DI on point for those, yeah.
This is looking really troublesome for Dyce.
Yeah.
The hero of time. This is a downer, gets the fair.
It's looking tough for Dyce. He's in a really bad situation, actually. Chris is already, he's already lapped him in percent.
Just keeps, like, throwing him off stage.
Yeah, that's the thing. In this matchup, Chris has just been keeping all the stage control and tuning. Oh, bad pivot throw.
Bad conversion. What was he trying to do there?
I don't know. I feel like he was trying to go for the maybe the grab to immediate back throw, but didn't work out. Yeah, Dyce just not able to punish right now. He's not punishing any of Chris's whiff
moves. Yeah. I think way too sluggish. Could be the nerves.
Oh. Oh, that would have been big. But like still, even now it won't kill with this rage. He needs to get at least 20 more percent on him to kill.
Good command grab.
Yeah.
Oh, hit him!
Oh, okay. He doesn't get killed with it. Oh, that was close. Oh, this should be a big punish? Oh, no, he just...
Those barrels are actually really hard to punish. Oh my god.
Oh, okay. Okay, at least he gets the dash attack.
He's walking around. He wants that down tilt.
Yeah. Chris wants that down tilt. Dyce wants that bomb. We'll see how it goes. And yeah, that's one way that Toon Link does have an advantage in that kind of position, because if he throws bomb and Chris throws banana, then it's just going to eat the banana and go through. Oh, Chris wants that cheese.
Oh, that's it. He gets it. Won it, he got it.
Yeah, there were too many times where Chris actually could have punished. But, I mean, sorry, Dyce could have actually punished with an up smash or something. But, unfortunately, it was just a little too slow.
Way too slow, actually. Oh, but we're still going to see more of him in loser's bracket.
Yeah, for sure.
And Chrim has a cloud, I didn't know that.
Yeah. He does have a couple other characters he does keep under his pocket for very rare instances, but... Yeah.
Like, everyone has a cloud, right? Let's be real honest.
Yeah, but, like, rarely will someone, like, who's so dedicated to one character actually pull out another,
right? You're right. Especially, like... In-